Bailey.
Hello there, Ben.
Oh, no.
What's up, lad?
Well, I didn't recognise you at first.
Yeah.
Are you home on leave or what?
I've come back.
How long for?
Just 7 days.
They have gear some kit, don't they?
Aye.
Pretty real, that lot, man.
Aye.
Let's have a look at it. It's heavy, innit?
It's tint loaded. How's Mum and Dad been?
Well, they're all right, though.
I bet he's making a right packet. Weight war and price of beef and all.
I don't know.
Visit back, lad, before you start getting ideas.
Where you been, Mr. Bailey?
France, Belgium. Flanders, I think they call it.
What's it like in France?
Like? I don't remember. I'll see you then.
My name's Philip.
Madagascar, to Mum and Dad.
Aye, I will.
City boys aren't used to this, lad. Bring us that water, will you?
Shouldn't work so hard.
Ta.
Oh, you're gonna catch a death of cold.
Oh! Oh! Just look at this. Just look. Yeah, just a bit.
Don't get blisters in our family.
No, I'd not. Just...
Are you still set on going to that meeting today?
Yes, love. Yes, I am.
The village is going to be swarming with soldiers and police. It's like putting your head in a noose at the last minute.
We'll be able to slip in, slip out. No one will notice us.
But why take the chance?
Because I want to hear him speak. I want to hear Lansbury speak.
But we can hear Lansbury speak when we get to London.
Look. It's been 2 years now, 2 years of concerted effort trying to get someone of his stature to come and speak. We've finally made it. I'm not going to miss it, not for anything. Besides which, I'm fed up of hiding away, skulking away like a criminal. I want to get down to London, where there's others that feel like us, and do something.
That's all the more reason for not taking a chance just before we're going to go.
Saying I do get caught.
What happens then?
Every time one of us gets caught, it gives us an opportunity to say what kind of a crime this war is. And the more public it is, the better. I mean, it helps to strengthen and encourage people already opposed to the war but are too afraid to say so.
What? What is it?
Police.
Where?
They're here. They're on the way to the farm. They'll be there by now.
You go with Ben. Go on.
Come on.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Matthews. We've got to have a look.
We've had no call to have police here. And there's no one in there. Nor in there. Don't know why you're looking.
Satisfied then, are you?
Fair enough, Tom. Look. We have these jobs to do, you know.
Well, I never thought we'd have come to this.
What's in here, Tom?
Well, have a look.
Just the one room, is it?
Ah.
been looking.
They're looking all our lass.
Have any of them been out the back?
They're all over. There's a couple in there. There's one there. They're all over the bloody place. I don't know. It's Philip they want.
What do you want, then?
Have you seen him, Sarah?
Seen who?
Your husband.
I haven't seen him.
Sarah, it's the military involved now. The Military Services Act. If they don't find him, they've classified him as a deserter. You know what that means?
I don't know where
You
he
know
is.
Where he is, but...
I've no idea where
Sarah,
he is.
When did you see him last?
About 2 weeks ago.
What about you, missus?
This lass says.
There's nobody seen or heard of him.
Sergeant. We've looked in here, we can't see him anywhere.
Seems pretty hopeless. Go right down the outside of the perimeter of the farm. You come to the other side and meet him on the far wall. See, them pacifists are holding a meeting in the village, Tom.
Oh, aye, I didn't think they'd allowed it.
Oh, they're within their rights. Yeah. Mind you, the recruiting people are having a demonstration at the same time. Will you be going?
Oh, aye. Ask me there.
I'll see you there, then. Aye. We'll show those pro-German bastards where to get off. All right, now, if he turns up, and he will, when he does, get in touch with us straight away. Is that understood?
Aye.
All right, missus.
Aye.
All right, Tom. Good afternoon.
What should we do?
I'll only be back.
Should we leave?
Yes, I think we'd better go.
Now?
Yes.
This afternoon?
This afternoon.
Come on.
My father, matches, please.
I'll bet you don't.
Why don't you join the army and do your bit like everybody else, eh? What makes you so bloody special? You split this family up from top to bottom.
That's not true. Been over and over us thousands of times now.
He's broke the law and the police are after him.
That's not necessarily wrong.
Everybody's out of step, only Philip.
I don't feel that, Mr. Matthews. There's thousands that feel exactly the same way as I do.
Not in this village, there isn't.
I saw Mr. Bailey today. He's home on leave.
Ronnie Bailey?
Hmm. John Stampede.
Well, there's a fella. You've got four kids to worry about.
And what's going to happen to them if he gets killed? You ought to be proud that you've got a son-in-law who'll do right, do what he thinks is right.
Do you know them last few ribs on?
I don't know where you'll put it on. I wouldn't have had to worry if he'd have done the right thing in the first place.
He's doing the right thing.
I'm doing what I believe to be the right thing, Mrs. Matthews.
But what is the right thing? Can anybody tell me what is the right thing?
Mr. Matthews, I don't want to fight this war because I don't think it's right to kill people for any reason. That's one thing. And another thing is, it isn't our war. It's nothing to do with us. This war should be fought in Serbia, in Austria. It's nothing to do with English people. We are being forced by your and our peers and masters to fight people who could be our neighbours. How would you feel if someone came to you, gave you a gun, and told you to shoot Mr. Emsley round the corner? How would you feel? That's exactly the same situation. We, the working classes of England, are being forced to fight and kill the working classes of another country, and there's basically absolutely no difference between us. If you believe really strongly that this war is right, why don't you also believe that those who dreamt it up shouldn't go and fight it? Because those who made the war aren't fighting it. They're sitting in desks in Whitehall, and it's the likes of us that are fighting it. It's not our war. That's what I believe to be wrong.
But of course it's our war.
Why is it? Tell me why it's our war.
You've got... This is all that I know, is that Germany has invaded Belgium. They've raped, they've robbed, and they've pillaged, and they've burned the land. Do you want that to happen in this country?
How do you know that
that overrun this valley?
Have you never heard the word propaganda, Mr. Matthews? Have you never heard that people make up things in order to whip up conscription? That's what's happening now.
But all we know is that there is a law to this, and we've got to abide by it.
But laws are not always right, Dad.
But if he'd have joined up in the first place, we wouldn't have had Bobby's coming here.
Well, there's going to be no more trouble now because we're off.
It isn't exactly easy, you know, what we've chosen to do. It's not exactly the popular path.
All right. I see it's no use arguing. You were going to London. How are you going to manage?
Phil's got some friends in London.
Yeah. That's what bothers me. Anyway, I need some money.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Some more ribbon on.
I don't know where you were putting it.
And for God's sake, when you get down there, keep your nose clean. There you are. There's £10.
We don't need all that, Mr. Matthews.
Check it.
Go on, lad. Put it in your pocket.
Thanks, Dad.
I'll pay you back, every penny.
Just look after her. That's all the payment that I want.
I think we ought to go, Philip.
We're thinking of getting the afternoon train.
Well, you better watch that demonstration against your Quaker friends.
Oh, yes.
All them fellas have had a belly full of beer, and they'll be itching for anything.
Are you going to that meeting, Dad?
I must do, mustn't I? Got to show where I stand. Anyway, there'll be plenty of people in town, and you should be able to slip through. And don't forget, use your loaf.
Can I come with you, Dad?
No, you can't. Enough we are going off without you starting.
Well, of course you can. There'll be bands and there'll be plenty marching up and down. Of course you can come.
Real.
So don't forget, doors all or something to you.
Yeah. I'll be all right.
Take care of yourself.
Trust I will. I know what I'm doing.
Leave it. She'll be all right.
Do you reckon Phil's a coward then, or what, Dad?
A coward? No. He's not a bad lad, really. His brain's a bit too active. That's what comes of reading too many books.
I can't understand him. If I got half a chance, I'd be in army like a shot.
Of course you would, lad. You're not old enough, are you? And I pray that it'll all be over before you.
Well, I'm nearly 17. If you volunteer, you know, instead of being fetched, you can choose your regiment.
Don't talk so bloody daft.
are you?
Better.
Oh, I'm better. Is Slav
near, Isaac? No, not yet.
Hey, look, there's our Sarah and Philip here.
I hope they're not going to that Quaker meeting.
It looks if they are.
They're silly buggers.
Come on, Dad, the band's playing.
Oh, no, I can hear it. They've all got fever in its head and fire in the belly.
Go on.
All that lot over there. Yeah. Come on.
Stand on this platform as your mayor today with three distinguished citizens who are going to address you. Firstly, our trade union official, Mr. Sam Holdsworth.
Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, comrades, comrades all, the workers of each of the countries that are now involved in this great conflagration have no quarrel with each other. But having willed the powers, then we must accept the consequences. Therefore, all able-bodied men must be armed and trained, ready to defend the institutions that we hold most dear. It is said by some of the ALP, MacDonald, Snowden, and George Lansbury, who argue against conscription. Hasn't the trade union movement always argued for compulsion for our trade union interests? Don't we say it is right that we should compel people to respect our trade unionism and our trade union advances? How then can these gentlemen of the ILP oppose compulsion when it's not only for our very wages and conditions, but it's in defence of our life and our democratic institutions?
Well, friends, this is a time of great trial. Not that our beliefs are being tested, for they've been tested through the centuries and have been found to be true. Rather, it is we ourselves who are on trial. Our courage and our strength as individuals before God. In this difficult situation, how welcoming it is to have George Lansbury with us here this morning.
May I suggest that Mr. Lansbury be given a visual ovation by the audience showing and waving the handkerchiefs or the newspapers or whatever. The applause in the usual way could well be interpreted as being an act of provocation by the poor misguided people outside.
Yes? Are you agreed that we do this? Thank you very much.
My friends, as your chairman said, we are meeting at a time of great trial and suffering. We see it in the eyes of those most near and dear to us, those who think like us that war is evil, so evil that we can take no part in it.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Whereof take you up the whole armour of God, so that ye may be able to withstand the evil day. Those were the words of St. Paul. But the psalmist might well add the postscript, he who is not with me is against me. Those words of St. Paul, written nearly 2,000 years ago, have an important message for each one of you today. Every Christian must be prepared to go down into the arena and fight God's fight. The Bible represents the world as a great battlefield, a battlefield between good and evil. And so I say to every able-bodied, loyal, brave Englishman, if you wish to remain a Christian, you must go forth and conquer that evil. You must present yourselves at the headquarters and say, I am ready for duty. I am ready to fight. I am ready even to die for my king, my country, and the Christian truth. Amen.
Thank you, Vicar, for those words of comfort and encouragement. And now it is my pleasure and privilege to invite Colonel Crowther to address us all.
I'd like to begin by saying that I consider the decision to conscript not only unnecessary, but a slur and an insult to British manhood.
The question Christians must continually ask themselves is this: is the ideal true and real in our hearts? Are we bearing the burden of others? And when I speak of others, I'm thinking in particular of those 16,000 conscientious objectors whose refusal to take up arms against their fellow men has already exposed them to all kinds of unspeakable horrors. Not just the jibes and insults of drunken patriots, but the torture and degradation being inflicted on them in the camps and prisons of England.
Mr. Chairman, I have only one criticism to make of the Speaker, and that is when he claimed there were 16,000 conscientious objectors in this country. Correction, Mr. Speaker, there are now 16,001. When I recently went before the appeals tribunal to register as a conscientious objector, I was turned down. I just could not see Jesus Christ in khaki. I could not see the Son of God armed in one hand with a bayonet and a machine gun, on the other hand, a Bible. My wife and I...
Bank Farm Glass Houses, a librarian. You were charged that on the 7th June 1916, being a person liable to conscription, did fail to report for duty, contrary to Section 1 of the Services Act 1916. Do you plead guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
Be seated. Yes, Constable.
Your Worships, yesterday morning, constables visited Quarrybank Farm and carried out a search for Philip Hargreaves. He was not found. Later the same day, the police were called to the market meeting hall where there was a disturbance. Hargreaves was seen and I arrested him under the Services Act 1916. He has been detained overnight in the cells to appear at this court.
Hargreaves, stand, please. You may now make a statement, if you wish, in mitigation to the bench.
Sir, I am a socialist, and so hold in all sincerity that the life and personality
of every man is sacred, that there is something of the divine in every human being. I cannot uphold this war, and therefore I cannot, in all conscience, advise anyone else to enlist or to take part in what I myself believe to be wrong and wicked. A country, as an individual, must be prepared to follow Christ if it is to call itself Christian.
Have you finished?
I have, sir, yes.
How old are you?
I'm 22.
Conscience, my lad, means nothing to me unless it's educated. Here you are, 22 years old, and already you're telling us how to run the world. You've seen nothing, you've experienced nothing, you know nothing. The Bible says, I came not to bring peace, but a sword.
Christ also said, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, pray for them that despitefully use you.
But that was only in personal matters, not national ones.
My position is a personal one.
I think we've heard enough. These people are a greater menace to Britain than the Germans. They say conscience makes cowards of us all, and I think this man is nothing more than a cringing little coward.
He's got more guts than you'll ever have. If you're a coward, join the army and do what you tell him to do.
Madam, if you cannot control yourself, you will have to leave the court.
What you need is discipline, which I'm sure the army will be only too pleased to provide. The fine is £2 for failing to report. Take it, he's yours.
Mind a bit of
no, I'm game with you. Well, he's charming. We've got to look after him.
Thank you.
I've been over there about 3 months, you see, and this message comes. Did you know what happened? We've been waiting for him, haven't we? We had the big guns, they opened up on him, and then the lads went in with him. There was guts and blood, and it was just like one big
still. Hey, look, come and join us, girls, or what? Hey, love.
Come and join us.
Come and join us.
Come on, very
come
good.
On.
Last fling before we... Yeah, last fling before we go to France, you know what I mean?
Do you like it? Gives you a good tickle.
The grey ones as well?
Yes, them and all of them. They come with experience. Come on, don't play hard to get. Last tram goes at 11.
Come on, he's a bit shy, he's driving.
Come on. But, come on.
Wrong. The bitter and
sweet stout, please. I won't go down to them trenches no more, where the Jack Johnson Browns and the cannons they roar. Take me over the sea, where Jerry can't get at me. Oh, Mar, I'm too young to die. Jack Johnson Browns and the cannons they roar. Take me over the sea, where Jerry he can't get at. Oh, Ma, I'm too young to die. I want to go.
Church of England, sir.
O-E-M-Z-T-C.
Right, stick the words. Name, lad?
Ben
Matthews.
Right.
Cheers,
mate.
Cory Monk Farm.
Just a minute, lad. Come back, come back. Just a minute.
Again. Turn around, cross your arms.
What's your religion?
Come.
Church of England.
Yeah. Right.
Next one.
Right, stick to the left. Have you
failed,
doctor?
Name? Paul Taylor.
Paul Taylor.
Can you read from F? His heirs and their successors, his heirs and their successors.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Kiss the Bible.
Read it.
Hand it back.
Read it.
And report to the
sergeant. He had an illness, is the talk.
Next. Well, like chicken pox.
Put the Bible in your right hand.
Can you just read that line?
I swear.
DLN.
DLN.
Serve His Majesty the King.
BTR. FZPD.
Good.
And say after me, I swear.
I swear.
To serve His Majesty the King.
To serve His Majesty the King.
His heirs and their successors.
His heirs and their successors.
And His generals set over me.
And His generals set over me.
By His Majesty the King.
By His Majesty the King.
His heirs and their successors.
His heirs and their successors.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Kiss the Bible. Hand it back and report to the sergeant down in the hall.
Next.
Take the Bible in the right hand. Say after me, I swear. I swear. To serve His Majesty the King.
To serve His Majesty the King.
Recognize your authority.
Come to attention when he speaks to me!
Come to attention!
I don't recognize the authority of the army.
What the bloody hell is that in Scotch Mist? Pick that rifle up! Are you gonna pick that rifle up?
No.
Private Westphal! Daniels! W!
Come on, W! You're like a lot of fairies, come on!
Fallen! Fallen! Left! Turn! Are you gonna turn? Take all of his head! Left! Turn! Right turn! Left turn! Faster! Right turn! Left turn! Right turn! Left turn! Right turn! Get him around! By the front! Quick! March! Left, right, left,
come
right,
on.
Left, right!
March!
Come on!
Come on! Bloody pick your feet up!
Hold!
Take him out!
Stand still! Left! Turn! Get him around! The last chance! Are you gonna pick that rifle up? Are you gonna pick that rifle up? Left! Turn!
Come on,
one either side of him! One either side of him! Double! March! Left, right, left, right!
Come on!
Fire! By the left! Double! March! Come on, it's a bloody brother, like Graham, get going!
Shut it up!
Come on!
Come on!
What's wrong with him?
Come on,
be honest there! They've refused to be honest! Drag him up to that! Put him over it!
Over the net! Come on!
Come on, laddie, move!
Come on! Get on!
Come on, boy!
Come on!
I've got bloody berserk in a minute!
Come on!
Get it up, Corporal!
Come on!
Come on, get it up!
Get him!
Get going! I'll give you it!
Come on!
Come on!
I'm gonna move on!
Come on!
Come on!
You should be over now!
Get over there!
I'll bloody throw you over! Come on! Come on! Come on, get hold of him, Corporal! Throw him over if need be!
Come on!
As long as he lands on his feet without his rifle in the shed! Come on! Come on, Hargreaves! Go, or I'll scout you when you get down here!
Come over!
Come on!
Come on!
Get in that tank, come on, Corporal! Pick him up! Drag him over here! Come on! Let's have him over this point! Come on! Come on, for God's sake, get over! Come on!
Situation, sir, is no improvement with him. He's still as bad as ever. He's still refusing orders from my corporals and myself.
Bring that man here. This really is a waste of time, you know. You're in the army whether you like it or not. You've made your protest, so why go on with it? Very well. You'll be taken in irons to Langard Fort Harwich, and from there you'll be shipped to France. If you continue to disobey orders, you'll be shot.
You have no right to do that. It's illegal.
The army doesn't give a damn for Asquith or Parliament. Either you obey orders, or you face the firing squad. Carry on, Sergeant.
Sir! Fall in the platoon!
Firing! Get him, woman!
Excuse me, is this an old conscription office?
What is it you want?
I'm looking for Sarah Hargreaves. Do you know her?
Mrs. Hargreaves?
That's right. She does work here, doesn't she?
Who wants her?
Well, she's my sister.
Oh, I see. Just a minute.
She hasn't gone home, then?
I shouldn't think so. I'll see if I can find her.
Thanks very much.
Here, there. She's that address you were looking for. Will you look after things for me? Who shall I say it is?
Oh, just tell her it's Ben.
Ben?
Yeah,
right.
Please. Thought I might have been a bit late. Thought she might have gone.
She's probably upstairs. Would you like to take a seat?
Oh, yeah, duh.
Ben!
Hello.
Oh, a nice surprise.
Are you coming?
Finished.
I didn't know you had a brother in the army, Sarah.
Oh, neither did I. He took it in his head to run away and join up.
Are you all right to come in here?
Yes, of course it was.
Are you all right, then?
Looking very well.
Uh-huh. Good night, then.
Bye.
Thanks for your
time. Good night. George Lansbury. Have you been out since?
No, have I, Egg?
Don't you think you ought?
Well, we never had a chance. This is the first bit of free time I've had.
What do you think about me, man?
Well, I'm making her allotment, you know. Send her a few bob every week, mate.
Thank you.
I should be able to go and see you, because we should get a bit of embarkation leave, like, before we go to France.
Is that where they're sending you?
Sounds like it. Well, to joint battalion, then we're off to Ireland, like.
You're going to Ireland?
Well, don't start your politics, Arky.
I'm saying no.
You wouldn't need to say it, your face says it for you. I've got to do what I'm told, don't I?
I expect that's what the German army said as they marched into Belgium.
You're not comparing us with them, are you?
Why not? The Irish have got as much right to fight for their freedom as the Belgians have.
Get off. Honestly, I've got to do what I'm told. I've got to fight who I'm told to fight.
And you don't think about why or who or what you're doing it for.
Shut up, man.
Sweet.
No, thanks.
Cup of tea?
Oh, yeah, lovely.
Like it?
Yeah, it's not bad. I say all this jungle's not yours, is it?
No, it's all part of it. Part comes in with a rent.
Oh, I see. Have you read all these books, then?
Most of them.
Seen better days, some of them.
Don't be so nosy. Come here and let's have a look at you.
Hey, Alan.
Sprouted up a bit, haven't you?
What?
I think so. Not managing to put much weight on you, either.
Well, you run about too much in that gang.
Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, it's all right.
Really?
Yeah, it's not so bad.
What I can't understand is why you've gone and signed on for 17 years.
Well, why not? Hey, by the way, have you heard out from Phil? How's he doing?
I don't know.
Well, don't you write to you?
Well, he did too, sent to France.
What's he doing in France?
God knows what's happening. I wouldn't have known out about it, except one of the fellas that he was with managed to throw a letter off train as it went through London.
Have you heard of since?
Army pretend they know not about it.
Well, you've a right to know you. You're his wife. You can demand it.
Are you going to tell me how I can?
Well, I mean, I don't know how exactly, but there must be something you can do.
We've had MPs, including Philip Snowden, asking Asquith questions in the House.
What did he say?
pretends he knows nought about it.
Well, somebody must know something about it. It's obvious.
Well, I don't know how you start to find out. Seems army can do just what they want.
No, there must be a mix-up somewhere.
A mix-up? Sometimes you're so bloody naive.
What do you mean? It's obvious there's a mix-up. Have you told him you're his wife and that? I mean, there must be somewhere.
They know exactly what they're doing. They're not mixed up. They know what they're doing. It's just that they're not going to tell anybody. One of these days, you're going to wake up to what's happening, and then it's going to be interesting to see which side you fall down on.
I hope you won't jump down my throat every verse end.
You can't have any sugar in your tea.
That's all right.
I mean, there is a war on. Perhaps you haven't noticed.
I didn't know about that. Poor bugger.
Poor bugger.
Si le camion vous voit, ils vous tueront, vite! Venez vite! Il arrive! Vite!
Shooters, do you?
The army's capable of anything. I ought to know. I've been soldiering for 2 years.
Oh, you're a deserter then?
Well, let's say I had a good look at the menu and walked out. Any doubts I did have were confirmed.
Mm.
How about you? What burns you up? Religion or politics?
Oh, both, really.
Yeah, with me, it's politics. Full-blooded socialism and up the revolution.
I'm a socialist too.
Well, you ought to know better then, didn't you?
What do you mean?
Well, all this talk about right and wrong. It's just the boss's propaganda to keep us in line, yeah.
I've got to pick up an old
head. Get away from you, will you?
I'm no pacifist. I'll fight in a war. But I'll fight in the only war that counts, and that's the class war. And it will come when all this lot's over.
Just look around.
Shut up, Mean. Shut up. Exactly what he said.
Just look at the evidence of your own eyes, and you should know you've lived through it. How can you possibly justify violent solutions after I've lived through all this mess?
Hmm. Look, the only way to end war is to establish socialism, correct?
Correct.
Socialism is international. The working class is international. And wars are national when the ruling class falls out with itself. Correct?
Yeah.
Well, how do you think you're going to stop the buggers then? By turning the other cheek?
Thank you, Bennett! Huh? Come on! Come on, lad!
Look where it's got you. Have a look. Hasn't got them much farther either, has it? But we're not going to get socialism added to us on a plate because we ask for it like polite Christians. The bosses enjoy their wealth too much. They're not going to hand it over just because they lose it in the election.
Corporal!
I've got quite enough on my plate without worrying. I had a whole lot of bloody conscientious objectors.
On the double!
Now, Corporal Hughes, will you get these conscientious objectors falling up over there? I want to talk to them. Sir?
Right, get firing three rounds. Move!
Pretty scrappy, lad, aren't they?
Yes, sir. One or two bad ones.
Come on, come on,
come on. Right, now you listen to me.
Sir Major, will you keep those cops quiet when I'm talking?
Keep quiet in the wagon, then!
Let me remind you that the front line is less than 2 miles from here, which means that you're on active service, and if you persist in disobeying orders, you will be shot. It's as simple as that. Now, it's not as if you're being asked to kill anyone. You can serve your time as non-combatants, provided that you accept army discipline. Now, what's wrong with that?
It would be an act of cowardice on our part if we were to accept.
An act of cowardice? That's a strange choice of words coming from one of you lot.
Any work that we did would only mean that we were releasing other soldiers to do the killing for us.
In which case, it would be their finger on the trigger and not yours.
Yes, that's what I mean.
Well said, sir.
What's your name?
Booth.
Sir, when you address me, it's sir.
John Booth.
Are you one of these socialist fellows, Mr. Booth?
No, I'm a Quaker.
A Quaker, and that makes you something special, does it? The rest of us can get our bloody heads blown off, but not you. Oh, no, you're a Quaker. You're different, you sanctimonious little bastard! Corporal Cummings! Give our Quaker friend here a taste of action.
Two men falling, Maximum. Get him out of there! Move him! Get out of there! Get him out!
Now, look, I'm not going to waste any more of my time with you people. Those of you who are prepared to work, take one pace forward. Anybody else? Right, you fall out and join your platoon commander. Son Chadwick!
Sir!
Take these men to the front.
Move them, come on! Come on! Come on! Move on! Move on! Release!
Come on,
you're not gonna get it.
Rest of the fish.
Mrs. Hargreaves live here.
Who?
Mrs. Hargreaves.
Yeah, I think she's just coming. I saw her in
there. Here? What happened there?
It's me, George. Yes.
Hello.
Office gave me your address. Sorry to come here at this late hour.
Been out all day, leafleting. Is anything up?
Better brace yourself, girl. Some bad news for you. We found out today that the army have court-martialed another 30 men in France.
Philip?
Yes, he's one of them.
And what's he got?
Haven't been sentenced yet. Our information is, though, that the court's already decided on his verdict. Mind you, it's got to be confirmed. Doesn't mean that just because
they... What's the verdict, George? What have they decided?
The court's recommended death penalty for all 30. Come on now, girl, come on. It's not the end of the matter.
They're set on shooting and they'll shoot him and there's nothing anybody can do about it.
No, no. Army's gone too far this time. Government daren't allow it to happen.
And who's going to stop them?
Parliament.
Asquith.
Yes, a meeting's been arranged. Under-Secretary of State for War is going to make a statement about it in the House tomorrow.
I've heard him make statements before, and if they're out to go by, nobody's going to take any notice of them at all.
Take her out of your pocket!
Sergeant James! Corporal Donovan wants you to move over with equipment!
Prisoner guard! Halt! Sergeant James!
Sir!
Take over!
Sir!
Private Philip Hargreaves, 2770163 of the 2nd Eastern Company Non-Combatant Corps.
Step forward, Hargreaves.
Tried by field court-martial for disobedience whilst undergoing field punishment. Sentenced to death by being shot. Confirmed by General Sir Douglas Haig. And commuted to 10 years penal servitude.
Step back in file, Hargreaves.
Private John Booth, 2774276 of the 2nd Eastern Company Non-Combatant Corps.
I want to speak to Kieran McMullen.
McMullen isn't here anymore. He went last week.
Well, I think he is.
He's not, I'm telling you.
We have information that he is here.
Oh, he's not.
Private Coleman! Robert Stubble! Get in and search the place. Private Richards, Davis, round the back, Davis!
Not there, Sergeant.
I passed the door. Come on. Cover him! Shut up!
Who are you looking for?
You know who you're looking for.
Hold for you there, Sergeant.
Hold it! All clear, sir. By the left! Quick! March! Left! Right! Left! Right! Left! Right! There!
Yes, sir.
We've got 20 men to build tonight.
No, you can't stay here.
Out of my way.
There's no room here.
You better stop
some. Half the men can't stay here. There's no room here. We never had any trouble. We don't want any trouble now. Pat, you have to get rid of those men.
Yes, we will.
Contain! Fall! Out!
You've got plenty of room.
Right inside.
There's
a
village down the road.
Yes, I'm sure there is.
You'll get me into a lot of trouble.
Oh, yeah.
All kinds of trouble.
Have you
spotted
it,
you fool? Oh, yes, yes. There we go.
Still lovely looking, lassie, aren't you?
Hey, don't keep it there. Come on, get round
here. Last time I made. See the woman. As lovely as you. He turned me in.
Round here. Fill that, eh?
Just got to fill that.
He wants some. Give him some. Give him some. Go on. Hey.
Did you like that?
Did you like that?
It was a knife. You can show her.
Hey, love. Oh. Hey, what about us over here, then? Hey. You've given it to the boys now. What about the men, eh? Come on, darling.
Come on,
darling. Come on. Don't be frightened. We won't bite you.
Come a long way.
Gives a nice smile, eh?
Come a long way.
Gives a nice smile, eh? Come on, give us a bit of
it. Hey!
That's one thing I like.
Bring it over here. She's now got you.
Oh, no, no. Come on. Nice bit of
cock, eh? Come on. You lost your tongue? What about singing? Hey, I know. What about a song? Nice music on a nice song. Harry, come on, get your fat arse off that chair. Come on. A nice bit of song. Come on.
Have you not?
You're as ugly as your daughter now. Look, we're only having a giggle.
Leave the girl alone.
Come here. You're on next.
We don't want you here.
Bloody day. Come on.
Lately last night, I was asked to a wedding. A wedding of
the see your legs, like a stuffed baby. Lift your skirt up, come on.
Honor new and intended lover. The thoughts of our old love.
Let's see your bum.
Come on, love.
No, enough of that crap. Give us one of them rebel songs. That's it. Give us one of them bloody Irish rebel songs you're always mouthing.
Yeah.
Come on. Hey, la, da, 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 da. That's go on, sing it.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on.
Was down by the glen side, I met an old woman.
She's just done this, hasn't she?
Same too. Oh,
young nettles, nor saw I was coming. I listened a while.
Hey, you mind after?
The song she was humming. Glorio, glorio to the bold Fenian men. When I was a colleen, there marching and drilling, awoke in the glenside, sounds awesome and thrilling. They loved poor old Ireland, and to die they were willing. Glorio, glorio to the bold Fenian men. Some died by the glen side. Some died mid the stranger, and wise men have said their cause was a failure, but they loved dear old Ireland and never feared danger. Glorio, glorio to the bold Fenian men.
Nachgat.
Glorio.
Lovely.
Good. Glorio.
She's lovely.
Oh, lovely.
Glorio, lovely.
I feel bad now.
Good
lad. Yes, very nice.
Very nice.
Very
Do you reckon we'll get to tonight?
No. I think somewhere like Tremor.
No, we'll not make it there tonight. Too far, though.
Well, if we ever get down to Cork, I'll take you to see this ankle of mine. get down there in a couple of days.
Yeah, we might let you get bloody shots when we get down there.
It won't make any difference with these uniforms on anyway.
What are you talking about? It's my dad's brother.
Oh, they're a wild bunch, them. Put your head around the door, shoot the bloody thing off.
What? Yeah.
And the door as well.
Hey, what's this about getting posted back home? Have you heard?
It's a load of lies, that. It's only rumours. Who said that anyway?
Company running heard it in officer's mess. They were
no
talking
chance.
About it.
There's no chance of that.
I can't see us getting something before Christmas.
We've got to sort things out over here first, haven't we?
There's too much going on. It's getting worse every day.
You're Irish? No, I'm not.
But listen, if your father's brother's Irish, your father's Irish, that makes you Irish.
Yeah, but I was born in London.
It makes no difference where you were born.
Of course it does. I'm born in London. I'm English, aren't I?
Does that make us out?
Of course it makes a lot of difference.
If your parents are bloody Irish, you're Irish, aren't you?
No, it makes
Well,
me...
you're tick enough, aren't you?
You're right on the wrong side.
I'll be here forever.
Where are you going?
No longer than
for a leg.
All right, thanks, Ben. Done all piss, there's enough of a bog, you know.
What do you want?
What?
I said, what do you want? Go on, you clear off home, it's best for you. Go on. Go on, Nipper, get off.
Where did he come from?
Here, I thought I told you to clear off.
Don't want it.
Go on, you clear off. I'll set the black and tans on you.
What's your name, son?
John, boy, what's yours?
You're a cheeky little monkey, aren't you? Hey.
Hey, you don't go sitting down there. If that sergeant sees you, he'll book your bloody arse for you.
Any fights?
Five fights?
Yeah.
Not getting you a bloody face.
Leprechaun shouldn't smoke.
Not a leprechaun.
Hey, have you got any sisters?
Yeah.
How many?
One.
That's one each.
It's not.
Of course they would.
They wouldn't. He's on his bits to hate just because he's ugly.
He was a bit one of them last night.
He wasn't with one of them.
He was, yeah, he was. Oh, dear.
I know.
You're a cheeky little bleeder, aren't you?
Who is?
You are. Who is?
No.
What would your old man say if he called you here?
Bring him down here and we'll shoot him.
Well, I'll shoot you,
though.
Yeah, I'll shoot your dad. I'll shoot your dad and I'll rape your mum.
Yeah, you would. Well, I'll use any fags.
Get your sister.
Yeah, I've got them.
Yeah,
I've
got
them.
Go on.
Go on, then. Go and get your
sister. Hey! No wonder Cromwell come and stuck with the likes of him knocking around.
Yeah. Please. Please. I don't
yeah,
want
go
to go.
Go piss off. You're going to get into bother. Go on.
Go on.
You best go on.
Get your head on you.
Yeah, I'll put my head on.
You cut your grey.
I can't put, hey, can't put it back. Can't
what
put
this?
It back.
Do you want it?
Yeah, come on,
yeah.
Come sit
here. Put his
on, Joe. Please don't
be. Come on, get us in.
Hey, you can pass
out. Sullivan, get the girl on the bike, or she will jump to bloody ground.
Stick him, George.
God,
give him a ghost when you catch him.
I warned you once, Sullivan. Stop passing the boat.
Come here.
Sullivan! I warned you! No. Stop passing about, you'll be on a bloody charge!
Take a man with you and find
sir! Matthews, cover me!
My God! What's going on, Matthews?
Oh, Christ.
Oh, Jesus, look at you.
Easy, lad. Take it easy.
What a bloody waste. He were a Republican, you know, if out. He has an uncle in Cork.
That's what comes with acting a fool. Now snap out of it! It's not the first dead body you've seen.
Seen too many for my liking.
Now watch out for that lad. Will I go back and get two men to clear this mess up?
I'm going to shoot you, you stupid little bastard. Get up! Pick that ass up. I don't know what other buggers are going to do, like. Come on.
Bring him up your mad house!
Right, Sergeant.
You've got to save yourself.
Come here, you bastard.
Yes, sir! You. House! Hooper! Get up there and stay with Solomon to follow orders! Copley! Give me that! Fall in under order! Come on, Dumbbell!
Fall in the back of the
bastard.
Corner.
Come here.
Fall in the back of the corner.